time of the drum and the song. The time of the first and most sacred school of dance had come.
In our time, the children of the children of Kahiki, in whom this ancient spirit lives, have come together once again in a celebration of the song and dance that comes to us from before history. The Hula Kahiko.
Ladies and gentlemen, live from Edith Kanaka'ole Stadium in Hilo, Hawaii, the 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Festival Hula Competition.
Good evening and welcome to the 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Festival Hula Competition. We are here live in Hilo. I'm Kimo Kahawan of K59 Radio, and anchoring this great event for the next two evenings with me is the Honolulu Skylark Jacqueline Leilani from KCCN Hawaiian Radio.
Sky? Good evening, Kimo, and welcome our viewers from KITV. We're very excited to be a part of the 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Festival. Tonight, the Kahiko Competition, where 30 halaus will be sharing the ancient dances of Hawaii.
And it should be exciting. Last night, this all started. Of course, it wasn't on statewide television, but it was exciting. The Miss Aloha Hula competition. And later on, we'll show you who the brand new Miss Aloha Hula title holder is here in Hawaii.
Tonight, the women's chant, Kimo, speaks of the goddess Hina from Molokai and her three devastating winds that were able to bruise skins and devastate lands. And the chant, the women's chant, was given to us by John Kaimi Kaua. And the Kane chant, Kimo?
Yeah, the Kane chant, the men's chant, because this is, of course, Kahiko dance, ancient Hawaiian dance. The men's dance focuses on the warriors of Molokai and how they were able to, you know, have different types of warfare, very effective. And so we should get from these dancers, male and female, very strong, emotional Kahiko ancient dancers. Should be very interesting this evening.
But right now, let's look at our royal court procession that opens every evening of competition.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are ready to begin with the entrance of the royal court here at the 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Hula Festival Competition. We are live. How about a nice round of applause for hula that lives here in Hawaii?
Treated to a very special session of last night's royal court procession with the royal guard.
Yes, and you know, it's amazing. I look at the scenery now here at the Merrie Monarch Festival here in the tennis stadium. You wouldn't imagine that last night it was storming, thundering, lightning. It was a very alive evening filled with the elements of nature. Rain coming across the auditorium. And here this evening, where we have elements focused in dance on the ancient, we have a very calm, clear skies in Hilo. It's just a beautiful time. The Royal Guard.
The Royal Guard is entering right now. They are from Oahu.
And, you know, this is a one-of-a-kind group. These young men have been involved with different drill teams in high school, and then they've gotten involved with the Royal Guard from the King's Village, and they have added to this Merrie Monarch Festival in the way that, you know, it should be. The
grandeur of Kalakaua. It is called the Merrie Monarch Festival because of the gentleman, King David La'amea Kalakaua, who helped revive the hula in Hawaii during his reign in the early 1800s. The guard's costuming, of course, representing that time period when Kalakaua had his own royal guard. All of their maneuvers and movements will be shouted in the Hawaiian language.
And now the sound of the pool, the conch shell. Vic Fergstrom Jr.
The Jubilee was celebrated as a season of festivity honoring Charles Miller's 50th birthday in 1886. In Jubilee in 1986, at the 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Festival, recreating the court of Kalakaua.
Thank you.
The pomp and ceremony of the 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Festival. We'll be back with more from the 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Festival right after these messages here on KITV, Channel 4.
Okay, I've been doing a whole lot of talking about a beer system made by a brewer who believes they make better beer. Well, what's it all mean to you, huh? Hey, buddy.
Hey,
to me, I could taste the difference right off. Brewer goes down smooth, easy, even feels less good.
Next thing you'll notice is another harsh aftertaste.
No bitterness. It's a great taste of Coors, minus any of the back line. I don't know about you, but for me, that's a different first taste.
No matter which baby you're looking at, we've got them all at Big Island Mazda Jeep Renault in Kona. Take this baby, the Mazda 323, beautifully styled, great economy. Or this one, the Jeep Cherokee, four-wheeling Big Island style. And for the elegance of Europe, the Renault Encore. So come on down and see Mom and her kids and pick out a new baby of your own at Big Island Mazda Jeep Renault in Kona, at the top of Alapa in the old Sears building next to Kona Auto Ashley.
Big Island SureSafe Markets are proud to distribute fine local products. Atabara's original potato chips since 1936. Also new jumbo carrot chips and Hawaiian crunchies in tubs, available only on the Big Island. And some Miko meat, quality meat products produced on the Big Island for over 75 years. Enjoy these fine local products at all Big Island SureSafe locations in Hilo, Keau, Kona, and Kamuela.
Equal access might seem confusing, so about a month before it's your turn to vote for a primary long-distance service, Hawaiian Tel will send you this letter explaining the whole process in simple terms. If you're still confused after that, you can call this special number. Simple enough? Of course, that's on Oahu, Maui, and the Big Island. It's this toll-free number on Kauai, Lanai, and Molokai. Just a little longer maybe, but still simple.
Where you have your IRA can be as important as the IRA itself. Does your financial institution offer the strength of one of the country's largest bank systems? First Interstate Bank Trust.
Are you getting a choice of IRAs in over 1,000 offices in 15 states?
You are with First Interstate. And can you consolidate all of your IRAs in one place and even borrow money for an IRA? If you can, your IRA is in only one place, the right place. First Interstate Bank.
Welcome back to our 23rd annual Merrie Monarch Festival. In the background, chanting of the Kekaulike lineage. Joining Timo and myself throughout the next 2 days of competition, we bring you live on-the-spot interviews from Channel 4's Emmy Cummingbond, and we'd like to welcome her tonight. Aloha, Emmy.
Aloha, Skylar. Good evening. I'm certainly honored to be back here again for one of the state's most prestigious events. And of course, it's always a pleasure to work next to Honolulu Skylark and Timo Kahawano. I just spoke to the people around me here in the stadium, and there's definitely an excitement building here for tonight's event. There's an unexplainable feeling. You kind of have to be here to know what I'm talking about. But through our coverage tonight, our live coverage, we hope to bring that feeling to you. Earlier, we spoke to a gentleman who is extremely important and special to tonight's event, as he has been in the past years. He is the founder of the Merrie Monarch Festival. He is none other than George Naope Akumahula himself. Here's George with some thoughts that we had taped recorded earlier.
My feeling for the hula has never changed. The hula to me is Hawaii. It's your sister and it's your truth. And today, with today's hula and all the new halawas and new teachers, the young teachers, are doing a beautiful job with the hula. And at this, I'm so happy to have been a part of the renaissance of the hula.
Judging over this prestigious event in this year's Merrie Monarch Festival, we have some exciting women and one gentleman who will be joining us this evening. Kau'i Rudemeister, Kumuhula from Windward, Oahu, prolific composer, honored in 1984 by the National Endowment of the Arts, is one of our judges for tonight's festivities. Edith McKenzie, Hawaiian historian, language and culture expert, professor at the University of Hawaii Manoa Campus, is judging tonight's festivities. Adeline Manukau Lee, Hawaiiana expert, has previously judged the Merrie Monarch Festival before. Gentlemen who gave us our competition chance for this year's festivities, Don Kaimikawa. Kumuhula in her own right, Leilani Stark Mendei, is judging tonight's festivities. And Ke Aloha Kalama, Kumuhula, and currently affiliated with the Pacific Museum. As an alternate judge in tonight's festivities, Leina Ala Kalama Haini, most noted for Dancing with the Brothers Casimero, is our alternate judge, and in from Kauai. We are very excited to have with us Lovey Atana. Currently doing a chant for the elements of Hawaii, the wind, the sky, the ocean. Judging tonight's competition, you are looking at a Kau I Rudimaster from Oahu.
Please join me in praising our God with a doxology. Imini kakou. Especially during this Easter season and during this Merrie Monarch Festival. Our beautiful cultural celebration of life that truly extends the celebration of life that is Easter, because it puts us in touch with the life of the risen Lord and the life that we live every day, where we see the traces of your kingdom living among us, and taking the celebration of life that we have in this Merrie Monarch Festival, we get in touch with the life of our people of this land, so rich in blessing, so in touch with the nature that is full of music and dance, so full of love and aloha. Bless all who give unselfishly to this event, especially those who work so hard and so faithfully every year. We offer to you all of our efforts and our energy as one hymn of soul. We'll be back with more of our Kahiko performance and the competition underway right after these.
this time?
You
know, with the First Hawaiian IRA loan, didn't they already tell you this?
Yeah, I can get a $2,000 tax deduction.
For just $67 a month. And the sooner you get an IRA, the better.
Yeah, you're right. I can't keep paying this off. Can I get my letter back?
Hey! Jesus! Stop!
It's brewed in America and in other great beer drinking countries. It's the only beer that must, by license and ability, only use Bavarian hops with flavor. And be sent back to Munich to be tested by German brewmasters. That's with the taste and quality. It's Lorenbrau. And that's how you get 600 years of Bavarian heritage in one smooth American beer.
In 1886, an incredible event took place one night on the grounds of Eolani Park. A new invention was about to be tested for the first time on Oahu. King Kalakaua assembled his troops as hundreds of curious townspeople gathered around. Then, shortly after 7 p.m., a switch was turned on. Suddenly, the miracle of electricity illuminated the palace grounds with a steady glow. The Hawaiian Electric Company has been providing that glow for almost 100 years.
Wake up to a Robert overnight in a place like Hawaii with a ground trip on Hawaiian Air. Or the Big Island with a Robert Rattle Cascade. How about Maui in a spectacular setting of an Outback Hotel? For just $170, two people can wake up to a Robert overnight with a despised companion.
One for 17
on
When the results of a nationwide customer satisfaction survey were released, one make of car placed second overall and ahead of every Japanese import and domestic model. What kind of car could be so thoroughly satisfying? Subaru. Why, to get any more satisfaction, you'd have to pay... Well, let's just say Subaru costs a whole lot less. Subaru. Beautifully inexpensive and built to stay that way.
Welcome back to Hilo Hawaii in the beautiful Edith Kamakaole Tennis Stadium. 200 threatening skies here in Hilo. We are starting and under the direction of lead vocalist, E.T. Lenny Miller, we are singing Hawaii Kamakaole. If I can take just a few moments to kind of run over some of the rules and regulations of tonight's competition in the Kahiko. We do have a choice number as well as a contest number that every halau must perform. We're going to talk more about those two numbers a little bit later.
You know, the whole idea of black, of course, has never been accepted as a part of the Merrie Monarch Festival with the competition. So every once in a while, someone will wear a black outfit, and it eliminates the point value immediately. There are many circumstances, but that's one. The color black, not permitted, really.
Black skin is acceptable, but not solid black costume.
Right.
The person who helps the chanter along are called ho'opa'a. And they must be dressed in the appropriate costume of the period. There is a time limit and a penalty of 5 points per fraction of a minute over. The time limit per number from the entrance of the Jimmy Mesa Hotel through the exit of the stage.
That includes the applause, too.
Right, a total of 9 minutes.
And this is where many Hula competitors, halal, have lost points in previous competitions. And the time starts when the only party begins, and once again ends at the total end of the performance when they leave the stage. So it's a key factor. And we're just about ready to begin, Sarah. Are you ready to go?
I'm ready, excited, Timo. Yes. Looking forward to a wonderful night of Kahiko Hula.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, to begin the Hula Kahiko, the ancient dance of Hawaii. And we ask, of course, that everyone come to your seat immediately or wait till the end of this number. Do not move in front of the judges. We are ready to begin. We want to give every hula halal the greatest attention since they have sacrificed time, energy, months of hard work to be here. We welcome you, the people throughout the state of Hawaii, from all of the Hawaiian Islands. And now, from Las Vegas, Nevada, under the direction of Kumuhula, Wayne Panoke. Hula halau o kahoone.
This is our first opportunity to see the Wahine competition show, which will always be performed in the
open. We will never forget our birthday, our home. Tonight, we present our Hokuku Amina Aloha, our gift of love to you, the people of Hawaii. Our choice to be equal for the Wahine is in honor of the people.
The first chapter chose to do tonight describes all the beautiful flowers, the woodlands, the winds, and the waters of Niuwini that in turn become a load for the high chiefess, Kipi'olini, concert with King David's glass door. The women carry ku'oli, a gift of offering. The hour 8. If you notice, their costuming is of the Monarch material. And their leaves of halal halal and leather leaf fern. And the halal colors of peace, comfort, and aqua.
Thank you.
Beautiful softness of the female hero. And of course, the leading singers of Yuku Ole. As they exit the stage here at the time of the day down here. The Royal Court announcement and of course the lovely Kahiko Kawana Ma, who has honored us as Grand Marshal of tonight's
festivity. He's a graduate of Komodo School. He was in the travel business here and then went to Las Vegas and he came back.
Beautiful to see that the perpetuation of our Hawaii is continuing in Las Vegas, and he has a competition of his own up there. But he started with the help of George Meditation about concert. He wanted to say, pay special attention to our Tony and Wahine set tonight. The winds that the women speak of are, of course, three windstorms of Tina. The first one is called the Ilinahu wind, which is a wind that bruises the skin. The second wind of Tina is called the Ilihava wind, which is an increasing rising wind, and used to devastate farmlands. The last is the Luluku wind, the massacre.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the island of Oahu, Honolulu, Oahu, our first in the common division, the men, we welcome, under the direction of Kumuhula, Al Bakashi, Kaua Kili Hunde.
We should get ready to see some fierce battles in our first tunnel group.
The 1986 Merrie Monarch Hula Festival is being sponsored in part by Aloha Airlines and by KTUA AM 670 The Big Island.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, live from Hilo, Hawaii, this group comes to us all the way from San Mateo, California, under the direction of their Hula Esther Correa. Welcome, Hula Halei, O Hula Nami.
Making their first appearance at the Merrie Monarch Festival, for the opportunity to see Hino and the devastating wind. The melody that is accompanying them, their great number is called Kumakumi Uwahakumi. Melody speaks, of course, of colors, wind, and smoke, conjuring up the colors of brave sky. This melody will be used with an ipu sute, made of two boys tied together, forming a hollow sound in the chamber.
Thank you. making their first appearance at the Merrie Monarch.
Earlier, we had an opportunity to talk with Kumuhula, Esther Correa.
I think the hardest thing is making them understand the hula, making them love the words that go into the hula and the gracefulness. And that's a little hard, mostly because I love to dance the feeling and teaching it, it's a little harder unless they have a lot of years in it.
Esther Correa, Kumuhula, and of course the hala we just saw, Kuule.
That is nice to realize that they're here for the very first time and they come in so disciplined, so clean a performance. I'm sure it surprised a lot of people, and you heard the response, didn't
it? Interesting, the hand motion to signify the winds of Hino, and of course the color is chosen to represent the island. Beautiful display. Women's group from the mainland California.
Oh boy, and we're headed for another surprise. You can see, folks, the men are ready to perform. And this is not their first performance coming with the Merrie Monarch. They certainly come from a long ways away. And I think we're just about ready for the competition to continue. Remember, there are 30 groups throughout this evening. And we welcome you to join us. And now we announce, ladies and gentlemen, our next Kahiko competitor, this time from Hayward, California. Under the direction of their Kumuhula, every lucky lucky. Welcome in the final division, that moment.
They, besides the competition plan, have chosen a ho'i'i aloha'i molokai. Continuing with the molokai theme, which tells the journey on across molokai. Friends of your disciples on their way to Kalua Ana. Kana Division.
Thank you.
up and down, not one fell. If one had, it'd been points against them. Helena Magruder from Hayward, California, in our final division.
Myrtle Beach.
Oh, what's that?
A McDonald's breakfast meal. Myrtle at Old Bakery.
What's terrific about it?
Oh, it's what? $7.69.
No, the deal. Well,
you buy any breakfast sandwich and large drinks, and you get hot hash browns free. Myrtle on water.
Last long?
Oh, yeah, 2 or 3 minutes. That's it.
The free hash browns.
No, only limited time. Boy, do something you can want.
Free hash browns when you buy any breakfast sandwich and large drinks.
Maybe with Mom Ruth, it doesn't work.
You're really on the move from coast to coast, so you need a bank that can keep peace with you. Well, only First Interstate has nearly 1,000 day and night credits, and it's part of Spirit. So you can get now instantly from coast to coast. So come to First Interstate. We're not just keeping coast. We're stepping the coast.
The 1986 Merrie Monarch Hula Festival is being sponsored in part by First Interstate Bank of Hawaii. We're not just keeping pace, we're setting the pace.
Welcome live to Hilo, Hawaii. And now, ladies and gentlemen, our next hula competitor, hello, from Waimea, Oahu, under the direction of their kumu hula, Hiki Lame Lua. Welcome. Hello,
all one there. The title used in this upcoming performance here is to emphasize Tina's warnings to the people of Molokai and to mimic the sound of thunder and the upbeating of the trees. The passing, of course, of the halau represents the green of the Ulu Nehu winds, the brown of the flood of the farmlands of the Ulu Hewa winds, and the red splatter of the Luluku wind. Their first chant tonight is called O Luluio Kalani. Dance composed in honor of Queen Luluio Kalani. One Kalaapoa named her heir to the throne. The kukui leaf and nut symbolize the island of Molokai.
Thank you.
Under the direction of P.E. Manilua, a nice crowd of dancers have been doing this lovely right here for the festivities of the 23rd Annual Merrie Monarch Festival. There's some general rules and regulations I'd like to remind our viewers tonight throughout the ITV. Each panel must have five or more dancers. One group kane, one mahini, four halal only in each individual. We've had an opportunity to tell stories with Merrie Monarch Kane, Kumu Hula, who is here participating in this year's Merrie Monarch Festival and her dedication to pursue Hawaiian studies. Here's Merrie Monarch Kane.
Whether you win or whether you lose, it's here to learn what other halals have. And someday you can pick up certain things that you don't have in your own halal. And this is what we have learned. As years go by, we just said, oh, this is beautiful, you know, and she said, why don't we try it our way? And the club it is, the Merrie Monarch, is something that you can learn from other halals.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from Honolulu, Oahu, under the direction of Kumu Hula, Noelani Shannon. Welcome, Noelani Hula Alau.
Besides the competition tonight, they have chosen to do Kau Pulehu, which is the district between Kuna and Waimea on the Big Island of Hawaii. In the south, this land is the man who waits to be caressed by the woman. The woman is described as the wind. Kaupulehu. The adornment worn tonight are fashioned again out of kukui from Olakai. And the colors chosen to represent the island.